In the previous video, we saw how complementary NMOS and PMOS transistors can be connected in a simple way to make the logical inverter function. Here we have a slightly more complicated circuit that performs the logical NOR function. At the bottom, we have two NMOS transistors connected in parallel. The two sources are connected together to ground, and the two drains are connected together to the gate output. At the top, we have two PMOS transistors connected in series, end to end, from the power supply to the gate output. Right now, all four transistors are off. To get a low voltage or logic zero on the output, I can turn on either one of the two NMOS transistors, or both. To make the output float, I must turn off both transistors. To get a high voltage or logic one on the output, I need to turn on both PMOS transistors. Turning off either one or both cuts off the output from the power supply. We cannot allow a short circuit path from the power supply to ground, which would quickly drain the battery. Furthermore, we cannot allow the output to float as it is doing now. To meet both of these requirements, let's connect the two pairs of gates as follows. One PMOS gate to one NMOS gate, and the other PMOS gate to the other NMOS gate. Now we have a two-input NOR gate. Right now, both inputs are low, so both PMOS transistors are turned on, and both NMOS transistors are turned off. The output is connected to the supply voltage and disconnected from ground, so the voltage is high, or logic 1. If the first input is high while the second is low, the output is cut off from the power supply because the first PMOS transistor is turned off. The output is connected to ground through the first NMOS transistor, so the output is low, or logic 0. If the first input is low while the second is high, the situation is the same as the previous one. The output is cut off from the power supply by the other PMOS transistor and connected to ground through the other NMOS transistor. The voltage is still low. Finally, if both inputs are high, the output is cut off doubly from the power supply and connected to ground through two NMOS transistors, so the voltage is still low. So if you play with this for a while, you see that the output is high only when both inputs are low, and always low otherwise. This is a logical NOR function. Also, the output never floats, and there's never a short circuit path between power and ground. To get the logical OR function, we connect the inverter gate to the output of the NOR gate. Imagine that a white light pushes up the inverter input, and the blue light pushes it down. Inverting the NOR function gives you the logical OR function. In the next video, we take a look at the circuit symbols used to draw schematic diagrams.